Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to day two of our workshop, Provinces in the Frontline. Today we have a quite eventful day. As you remember, we said we're going to take a deep dive looking at governance and leadership, as well as the issues of functional base. Yesterday we got lots of insights from the presentations covering wide range of topics from collaboration to adaptive governance. And we're going to link to that with our discussions today. Online, I've got Mr. Mduduzi, who is the head of policy unit from the Gauteng province, and is going to give us the welcome remarks. Mr. Mduduzi Mbanda, please go ahead and give us the welcome remarks.
Thank you very much, Thabo, to the colleagues, everybody who's on the platform. It's a great pleasure and a great opportunity for us to share with you what my colleagues Kamel and Ishmael have asked me to do, to do opening remarks today. I was very much fascinated with the work of what provinces have been doing yesterday. And I think it's a brilliant idea that we are meeting in the way we are meeting today. I must say that we want to first thank the colleagues from GTEC for this collaboration. I just want to say that one of the important things I've learned over time is that there is nothing as important as appreciating knowledge as a strategic resource, but also appreciating that knowledge must be shared, stored, but managed well for the development of others. And I'm looking at this as part of that experience. I would like to also acknowledge Chris Kuta, the head of mission from Canada. I must say that we are already doing a lot of work with Canada. Just last week, I was in a webinar with the York University on the transformative disaster risk governance webinar series on artificial intelligence. And part of the conversation was issues on data, using artificial intelligence to respond to the challenges brought by the pandemic. We've now also launched what we call the Africa-Canada Artificial Intelligence and Data Innovation Consortium. This will work across the continent in the with the universities that are based here. And I look at that work as well as part and parcel of what the COVID-19 has been able to do, bring the best out of us across the globe. And therefore, I'd like to thank the colleagues from Canada. And we really want to believe that the more we collaborate, the better. But also more we collaborate internally as the different provinces, as we saw yesterday, it will indeed assist us to achieve quite a great deal. I must say that quickly, my colleague Kamel did show you this. One of the important things just for us to say as the province of Gauteng, looking at ourselves as a city region, indeed we had to adopt agile governance structures, adopt systems in response to the pandemic. I must also indicate that when we developed what we call the plan Gauteng, Growing Gauteng Together 2030, we did a lot of prediction and modeling. But one thing we missed was to model the possible impact of COVID-19 or pandemics, as you would all know. We were really thinking that we were going to scale through and really achieve our targets by 2025 and 2030. But we have had to revise our work. Put together a team, as you heard yesterday, led by Mildred Nkopani on the PMO. I think that also is a useful way of managing government, as opposed to the number of things that we've been doing that have not really brought in innovation. But I think COVID-19 has really assisted us to invest in innovation, because one of our big vision as the Gauteng City Region is to become, to build an eco a system, an innovation ecosystem, really become a home of Africa, of artificial intelligence. And that can only happen if we work together with the rest of the universities, but also leveraging on data and so forth and so on. Well, we all know that COVID-19 has really disrupted our lives, but we also know that COVID-19 has impacted on food security, income inequality, exacerbated apartheid spatial planning. But we believe that with the work that we've been doing over a period of time, we can be able to salvage and can continue to build institutions that are resilient, but also create collaborations that can assist us to indeed go through this difficult period in our lives. Yesterday, I did get a sense that there was an issue about the number of jobs. I mean, I'm just demonstrating what happened just in quarter four of 2020 with regards to the number of jobs that we lost, to demonstrate the impact this had on the country and indeed on the province. Of course, we then think that the only way to return to a situation where we can get people working is to think and think deeper as to what could be the new ways that we can invest in bringing about economic activity and get people as much as possible participating in the economy. Of course, this includes working well in reversing the impact of the pandemic with regards to inequality, with regards to poverty, by as much as possible, taking into consideration the fact that we have put in place programs such as the township economy, we've put in place programs such as investing in SMEs, but that on its own requires a great of deal that we should partner with people. We therefore think that having listened to a number of presentations as of yesterday, there is a need to really invest in a coherent policy responses that are very clear with regards to what we must do on health. We're investing in structures, having learned from the study that was done by the team of GTEC and NRF, that there are a number of new systems and infrastructures that we should put in place so that indeed health must not only be viewed as an independent, but also health is viewed as a big contributor of social and socio-economic contributor, so that indeed as much as possible, we can work towards an inclusive Gauteng city region. I must indicate that our success in responding to the pandemic was really buttressed on partnership. As you can see, the partnership with GTEC, with NRF, and everybody else that comes on board is also because we ourselves partnered with these institutions to make sure that as much as possible, we can leverage and respond to the pandemic, because we don't have all the answers in government. And therefore, it is important to appreciate that with IBM, we created what we call a viewer, where we can be able to get to follow what was happening in terms of the epidemiology, the trend of the pandemic, where it was happening, and what kind of investments and interventions that we needed to do, buttressed on a geospatial planning in terms of geolocation, but also based on what we call the vulnerability index, which I'm very confident that my colleagues might touch on from GCRO, because we needed to know where people will be able to social distance and so forth and so on. And with that, we can be able to establish what we call ward-based structures and follow the pandemic and attend to where there are challenges in our communities. Of course, using artificial intelligence, we are now investing a lot with issues of population aggregation and being able to know where to start with our vaccine rollout plan. And all of this is done in collaboration and support of these institutions I've mentioned earlier. Because as I'm saying, we learned from the first wave and the second wave that the only way to respond to the challenges of the pandemic is to work in a collaborative manner. Of course, as I've touched on a bit on how we responded to the economy, we've appreciated that health is an important factor of our lives, and therefore we must not just see health there alone. A lot of the things we've done, as you would hear from the colleagues, was really assisted us indeed to say health is important and therefore it's everybody's problem. And that's why all the work done by the various committees, whether the economic work stream, whether the social work stream, the law enforcement stream, the government continuity work stream, at the heart of it was how do we get health back and get our infrastructure, our facilities rather, functional so that they can be responsive to the challenges of the pandemic. I must indicate that once more, at the heart of this was evidence, at the heart of this was data, at the heart of this was collaboration. And we are of the view that despite the negative impact of the COVID-19 on cities or in particular on ourselves, this has created us a lot of opportunities to appreciate knowledge, to appreciate data, but also to invest in policies that can help us respond to the pandemic and therefore ensure that going forward, we build sustainable, resilient cities or resilient systems in government so that we can be able to respond to ongoing problems and challenges that are facing us. Of course, we are now in a third wave. If I had an opportunity, I would show you that it started in Free State, coming into Sidibeng. The numbers are quite high. They are going up every day. But we are also being in a position to track that and in a position to intervene where we needed to intervene. So we are looking forward to another productive day, sustained engagement in growing South Africa. And I think we will continue to learn from a number of presentations that were done as of yesterday and going forward, try and institutionalize as much as possible the recommendations that have emerged from the study coordinated by GTEC and NRF. Thank you very much for the opportunity.